Hello everyone, let's start our second lecture on water transportation about harbor planning. So let's to be continue to our new topic, harbor planning.
Let's start harbor planning. So what is harbor planning? First of all, we have to decide what are the factors. Okay. Factors affecting the decision to build a harbor. The decision to build a harbor and its location will be determined by some basic factors like need for the harbor and economic justifications, whether that you really need a harbor, and if you need harbor on that locations, economically is justified or not. So this is the first factors affecting the harbor planning. Second factor is what? The prospective volume of seaborne commerce. Okay, so you can say that prospective volume. Okay, prospective volume of seaborne commerce. Third point, you can say that availability of inland communication by both land and water. So the need for a harbor may arise in a number of ways, such as for an example, we can say a seaport may be needed to serve a nearly inland city, which has grown to the extent of requiring an outlet for its foreign commerce. A naval base or a military terminal may be needed to supply an inland army or air base. So you can say naval base means military terminal for the military purpose. You can also take into account the factors that the need for a commercial port will arise when it is required as a shipping terminal for the commodity or a product which is being developed and for which no shipping facilities are available. So for preparation of a complete site investigation program, it is necessary to make preliminary studies and layout of the port. The investigation should contain site information from hydrographic and topographical surveys. So you can say that information we are getting first hydrographic and topographic survey. Okay, so this first. Second, also site information from subsoil investigations, means subsoil investigations at location of breakwaters, piers, valves, bulkheads, etc. And third, general direction and velocity of current in the area. So general direction and velocity of current in the area. So these are the factors affecting the decision to build a harbor. Again, continue to the section that site selection. Okay, site selection. So we have to kept in our mind some basic points before selecting the site of a harbor. So it would be safe and convenient and economically. So first point is availability of cheap land. Availability. Okay. If you find nearby area that available is very cheap, so you can. Okay. Second point is easy availability of construction material. So construction material cost is also a fact to harbor site selection. Third point is natural protection from waves and winds. Okay, so this is also necessary. Fourth is industrial development. Okay, of the area. Industrial development of the area. Fifth point, what? Seabed, subsoil and foundation condition. So you can say that seabed, subsoil and foundation conditions of that site. If they are not in a good condition to build a harbor, you cannot make. Sixth one is availability of electrical energy and fresh water. Electrical energy and fresh water. Okay. Now seventh, availability of labors. Okay. अगर लेबर्स ही नहीं मिलेंगे तो काम किससे करवाएंगे, ठीक है. सो सेवन पॉइंट. एट पॉइंट इज अ फेवरेबल मराइन कंडीशन. ओके, दिस इज ऑल्सो मराइन कंडीशन. एंड नाइन्थ वन, डिफेंस एंड स्ट्रेटेजिक एस्पेक्ट्स. ओके, सो डिफेंस एंड स्ट्रेटेजिक एस्पेक्ट. सो दिस नाइन पॉइंट्स, these 9 points you have to kept in your mind while you are going to select any harbor site. After site selection, the main point is the size of harbor. So size of harbor is depends upon, you can say, first point is accommodation required. Okay, second point is convenience for maneuvering and navigation. So this point is also an important point, maneuvering and navigation. And third one is adaptability of natural features. Okay, so after the site selections, the third point is come size of harbor. So first is accommodation required, second is the convenience for maneuvering and navigation, and third is adaptability of natural features. The size of harbor mainly depends upon the number and size of ships using the harbor. Okay, some of the biggest modern ships are 275 meter to 300 meter long and about 30 meter wide. So there should be a sufficient area for maneuvering them without collision. The existing site condition also will have an important bearing. Generally speaking, unless the harbor is natural one, its size will be kept as small as will permit safe and reasonably comfortable operation to take place. Also, the use of tugs to assist maneuvering of the ships may influence the size of harbor. The minimum harbor area is equal to the space required for the docks plus the turning basin in front of them. The harbor may be further restricted in area where the ship is turned by warping it around the end of the pier or turning in dolphin. Start harbor planning. So what is harbor planning? First of all, we have to decide what are the factors. Okay, factors affecting the decision to build a harbor. The decision to build a harbor and its location will be determined by some basic factors like need for the harbor and economic justifications, whether that you really need a harbor, and if you need harbor on that locations, economically is justified or not. So this is the first factors affecting the harbor planning. Second factor is what? The prospective volume of seaborne commerce. Okay, so you can say that prospective volume. Okay, prospective volume of seaborne commerce. Third point, you can say that availability of inland communication by both land and water. So the need for a harbor may arise in a number of ways, such as, for an example, we can say a seaport may be needed to serve a nearly inland city which has grown to the extent of requiring an outlet for its foreign commerce. And foreign commerce, a naval base or a military terminal may be needed to supply an inland army or air base. So you can say naval base for means military terminal for the military purpose. You can also take into account the factors that the need for a commercial port will arise when it is required as a shipping terminal for the commodity or a product which is being developed and for which no shipping facilities are available. So for preparation of a complete site investigation program, it is necessary to make preliminary studies and layout of the port. The investigation should contain site information from hydrographic and topographical surveys. So you can say that information we are getting first hydrographic and topographic survey. Okay, so this first, Second, also side informations from subsoil investigations, means subsoil investigations at location of breakwaters, piers, valves, bulkheads, etc. And third, general direction and velocity of current in the area. So, general direction and velocity of current in the area. So these are the factors affecting the decision to build a harbor. Again, continue to the section that site selection. Okay, site selection. So we have to kept in our mind some basic points before selecting the site of a harbor. So it would be safe and convenient and economically. So first point is availability of cheap land. Availability. Okay. If you find nearby area that available is very cheap, so you can. Okay. Second point is easy availability of construction material. So construction material cost is also affect to harbor site selection. Third point is natural protection from waves and winds. Okay, so this is also necessary. Fourth is industrial development, okay, of the area. Industrial development of the area. Fifth point, what? Seabed, subsoil and foundation condition. So you can say that seabed, subsoil and foundation conditions of that site. If they are not in a good condition to build a harbor, you cannot make. Sixth one is availability of electrical energy and fresh water. Electrical energy and fresh water. Okay. Now seventh, availability of labors. Okay. अगर labors ही नहीं मिलेंगे तो काम किससे करवाएंगे? ठीक है. So seventh point. Eighth point is a favorable marine condition. Okay. This is also marine condition. And ninth one, defense and strategic aspects. Okay. So defense and strategic aspect. So these nine points you have to kept in your mind while you are going to select any harbor site. After site selection, the main point is the size of harbor. So size of harbor is depends upon, you can say, first point is accommodation required. Okay. Second point is convenience for maneuvering and navigation. So this point is also an important point, maneuvering and navigation. And third one is adaptability of natural features. Okay. So after the site selections, the third point is come size of harbor. So first is accommodation required, second is the convenience for maneuvering and navigation, and third is adaptability of natural features. The size of harbor mainly depends upon the number and size of ships using the harbor. Okay, some of the biggest modern ships are 275 meter to 300 meter long and about 30 meter wide. So there should be a sufficient area for maneuvering them without collision. The existing site condition also will have an important bearing. Generally speaking, unless the harbor is natural one, its size will be kept as small as will permit safe and reasonably comfortable operation to take place. Also, the use of tugs to assist maneuvering of the ships may influence the size of harbor. The minimum harbor area is equal to the space required for the docks plus the turning basin in front of them. The harbor may be further restricted in area where the ship is turned by warping it around the end of the pier or turning in dolphin. Now let's the next important term is width. Width of the entrance to the harbor, or you can say the width of the entrance channel. To reduce the wave height within the harbor, the entrance width should not be more than that necessary to provide safe navigation and also to prevent dangerous currents when the tide is coming in and going out. The entrance width should be in proportion to the size of the harbor and ships using it. A rough guidelines in this regard may be, you can say this as follow. Means if you want for small harbors, you can say just 90 meter. For medium harbors, 120 to 150 meter. For large harbors, 150 to 250 meters. Now, width of the entrance channel. The entrance channel width is divided into three. Means maneuvering line width is equal to twice B. Ship clearance line width is equal to B, and bank clearance depends on the side slope. You can say this is a formula that L is equal to 4B plus 2, where L is equal to width of the entrance channel, B is equal to the beam of the ship, and this is the number in bank clearance. Now turning basin. The radius of the turning basin should be equal to 2 times the length of the largest ship calling at the harbor. So R is equal to 2L, where R is equal to radius of the turning basin and L is equal to length of the largest ship. So keep in mind, this L is length of largest ship. Smaller turning basin may be used if a turning dolphin is provided at the head end of the pier and the ship is warped around to this dolphin. Now another term is wave height. So wave height within the harbor. So what is the formula of a wave height? So you can say here small h is equal to capital H into the bracket under root b by l minus 0.27 under root d in the bracket 1 plus under root again b by l bracket closed. So here, what is the small h? Small h is equal to height of reduced waves and any point P in the harbor in meter. Capital H is equal to height of wave at the entrance. It's also in meter. Capital B is equal to breadth of entrance in meter. L is equal to breadth of harbor at P meter. And capital D is equal to distance of P from entrance end. So this equation is applicable to a distance of 15 meter. Okay, so this equation is applicable to distance of 15 meter from the entrance and the where the harbor is well protected by a vertical sea wall. So this is important only for distance 15 meter. Now again towards depth of harbor and length of the basin. So for ideal operating condition, the water in the approach channel, in the entrance and in the harbor basin should be of sufficient depth to permit navigation at the lowest low water when the ship is fully loaded. Basically a depth of 12 meter would take care of most of the ships. In case of super tankers of 1 lakh DWT, a draft of 50 meter would be necessary. The channel depth is generally determined from the following formula. So capital D is equal to D dash plus H by 3 plus D double dash. Now where D dash is equal to the draft of the largest ship to be accommodated and capital H is equal to the height of strong waves, crest to trough, and D double dash is equal to allowance for squat. The surface of the water is depressed slightly by a moving ship and some additional clearance of the bottom is necessary for this squat of the moving ship. So you can say the maximum harbor depth below lowest low water is achieved as follow. Maximum harbor depth is equal to loaded draft plus 1.2 meter when bottom is soft, or if we found when bottom is rock, so you can say the maximum harbor depth. Okay, so this is the maximum harbor depth is equal to loaded draft plus 1.2 or 1.8. So 1.2 for the bottom is a soft condition, and if we found that bottom is a rock, okay, rocky bottom, then you have to use 1.8. Now length of the basin. Okay, so first of all, generally the length of the basin should not exceed 2000 meter. Okay, so not exceed 2000 meter. The maximum length of a queue should be sufficient for mooring the longest ship or a largest ship expected to berth the queue. A berth with 9 meter depth can accommodate a ship 160 meter long. Okay, so 9 meter depth berth can accommodate ship 160 meter long, and allowing for 20 meter at both the ends of mooring, a total minimum length of berth would be 20 plus 160 plus 20 is equal to 200 meters. So on an average, 600 to 700 meter length may be sufficient to berth three ships. Now let's, the next important term is width. Width of the entrance to the harbor, or you can say the width of the entrance channel. To reduce the wave height within the harbor, the entrance width should not be more than that necessary to provide safe navigation and also to prevent dangerous currents when the tide is coming in and going out. The entrance width should be in proportion to the size of the harbor and ships using it. A rough guidelines in this regard may be, you can say this as follow. Means if you want for small harbors, you can say just 90 meter. For medium harbors, 120 to 150 meter. For large harbors, 150 to 250 meters. Now, width of the entrance channel. The entrance channel width is divided into three. Means maneuvering line width is equal to twice B. Ship clearance line width is equal to B, and bank clearance depends on the side slope. You can say this is a formula that L is equal to 4B plus 2, where L is equal to width of the entrance channel, B is equal to the beam of the ship, and this is the number and bank clearance. Now turning basin. The radius of the turning basin should be equal to 2 times the length of the largest ship calling at the harbor. So R is equal to 2L, where R is equal to radius of the turning basin and L is equal to length of the largest ship. So keep in mind, this L is length of largest ship. Smaller turning basin may be used if a turning dolphin is provided at the head end of the pier and the ship is warped around to this dolphin. Now another term is wave height. So wave height within the harbor. So what is the formula of a wave height? So you can say here small h is equal to capital H into the bracket under root b by l minus 0.27 under root d in the bracket 1 plus under root again b by l bracket closed. So here, what is the small h? Small h is equal to height of reduced waves and any point P in the harbor in meter. Capital H is equal to height of wave at the entrance. It's also in meter. Capital B is equal to breadth of entrance in meter. L is equal to breadth of harbor at P meter. And capital D is equal to distance of P from entrance end. So this equation is applicable to a distance of 15 meter. Okay, so this equation is applicable to distance of 15 meter from the entrance and the where the harbor is well protected by a vertical sea wall. So this is important only for distance 15 meter. Now again towards depth of harbor and length of the basin. So for ideal operating condition, the water in the approach channel, in the entrance and in the harbor basin should be of sufficient depth to permit navigation at the lowest low water when the ship is fully loaded. Basically a depth of 12 meter would take care of most of the ships. In case of super tankers of 1 lakh DWT, a draft of 50 meter would be necessary. The channel depth is generally determined from the following formula. So capital D is equal to D dash plus H by 3 plus D double dash. Now, where DS is equal to the draft of the largest ship to be accommodated, and capital H is equal to the height of storm waves, crest to trough, and D double dash is equal to allowance for squat. The surface of the water is depressed slightly by a moving ship, and some additional clearance of the bottom is necessary for the squat of the moving ship. So you can say the maximum harbor depth below lowest low water is achieved as follow. Maximum harbor depth is equal to loaded draft plus 1.2 meter when bottom is soft, or if we found when bottom is rock, so you can say the maximum harbor depth. Okay, so this is the maximum harbor depth is equal to loaded draft plus 1.2 or 1.8. So 1.2 for the bottom is a soft condition, and if we found that bottom is a rock, okay, rocky bottom, then you have to use 1.8. Now length of the basin. Okay, so first of all, generally the length of the basin should not exceed 2000 meter. Okay, so not exceed 2000 meter. The maximum length of a queue should be sufficient for mooring the longest ship or a largest ship expected to berth the queue. A berth with 9 meter depth can accommodate a ship 160 meter long. Okay, so 9 meter depth berth can accommodate ship 160 meter long, and allowing for 20 meter at both the ends of mooring, a total minimum length of berth would be 20 plus 160 plus 20 is equal to 200 meters. So on an average, 600 to 700 meter length may be sufficient to berth three ships.
I hope you can understand harbor planning. See you soon, and thank you for watching. Please subscribe.